Hat is good?
Yeah.
Hey everyone, welcome to the O'Neill National MX Update Show. I'm Don Maeda and I'm joined by my good buddy Jo Shimoda of the Monster Energy Pro Circuit Kawasaki team. Buddy, you're fresh off of your very first career national motocross podium, so congratulations.
Thank you.
How do you think the season's been going so far? Had a couple bad motos, couple good motos. Is it up to your goals?
First round was probably the worst round I did. I crashed on that one actually, and high point I crashed on the start, which I lost a lot of points there. So those are the two bad rounds, and other rounds I've been improving some stuff, position wise too, and for this round I improved a lot on starts, which helped me so much on the day. So it's been going better and better. Mm-hmm.
So I'm sure you came into the opener at Fox Raceway with your sights set pretty high, since that's your home track where you spin hundreds of laps every week, right?
Yeah.
What kind of things went wrong for you there?
Sorry, one more time.
What were your troubles at the opener at Fox?
I was just rushing too much, having bad starts, which, like, you know, Fox Raceways, like, they have the technical stuff, like you land a jump in corner right away, like they got like a dragon's back, like technical sections, and mm-hmm. I was rushing it too much, where it's like I'll lose my front end, like stupid mistakes. So that's why I just didn't go very well that day. Mm-hmm.
How do you feel your preparation for motocross has been between Supercross and this summer?
Oh, it was good. A lot of motos, for sure. Mm-hmm. But mostly, like, at first, I worked on my speed. You know, like, I would try to get a good speed, then do a moto on that pace. So mm-hmm. it's not like you're 2 seconds off doing 30s, like, which it's not really gonna help you once you get to the race. Like, if you're 2 seconds slower than everybody, then there's not really a meaning doing 30s. So mm-hmm. First I kind of catch up my speed, mm-hmm. and then I worked on the physical side.
Yeah, so your riding style, you're so smooth, right? Always looks so effortless and almost like you're not trying, right? So you're training with Yannick still, right, Carvella?
Yeah.
Has he ever tried to help you increase your intensity, maybe?
Yeah, for sure, definitely. Like, my style is good. Like, inside of the corners, like, I was not really not aggressive, but I was too late on the throttle, mm-hmm. and we worked on that and entry speed mostly. Mm-hmm. I was like too patient going into the turn and then turning instead of just go in and try to be quick as possible. So, the things are getting better for sure.
Yeah. It's funny because remember the first time we filmed for the Fast movie? We rented Paula Raceway, yeah. And I was watching you, and I was like, okay, he's just warming up. When's he going to start hauling ass? And I'm like, wait, he's going really fast, but he looks like he's cruising. You know, has that always been your riding style your whole life?
No, actually, like, since I trained with, like, Yanning, I used to be, like, one of those guys, like, try to go wide open, like, my feet everywhere, like, my elbows and hands are, like, off the bar and stuff, like, crashing so much. But, no, since I worked with him, like, we redid our fundamental stuff, mm-hmm. You know, like, at first, I would practice, like, one corner a day, like one corner for all day, mm-hmm. like we did that kind of stuff, and figure out a lot of things. And after a couple of years later, like I find myself like in a different style.
Yeah, you know what you do so good, I like to watch you, like, you know, even just regular day at Paris, you can go around an inside rut and stand up the whole time.
Yeah, mm-hmm. we did a lot of standing up too.
Yeah, so there's a lot of stand up drills, maybe stuff like that.
Yeah, definitely.
Cool. Okay, so you know, the season's been getting better and better. At Southwick, you get there, and you know, that's like everyone talks about how rough and gnarly the sand is there. What is your impression of Southwick?
Southwick, that was my first time there.
It was, okay.
Yeah, so, and I thought that, I mean, like, the out of all the Pro National track I've ridden, I like the best so far.
Oh, yeah.
I like the Millville. That's one of my favorite tracks. But the Southwick, like, I never really raced in a sand track.
Mm-hmm.
And having a sand track like that, it's kind of unique. Like, it's a different race. Like, I never get to practice that kind of track, so I really enjoyed it.
Mm-hmm. Do you think that your, you know, smooth riding style, a lot of standing up, with that, did that help at Southwick?
Oh, for sure. Like, play with the bumps. Like, I don't... You know, like, it gets rougher and rougher where you get, like, it's a straightaway, but you get the rollers
mm-hmm.
instead of, you know, attacking every single, each one of them. And I start to, like, I'll start, like, jumping and stuff, being creative. So I think that helped me a lot, saving my energy, too. So,
mm-hmm.
no, it was good, great track for sure.
Cool. So coming into Southwick, well, you qualified 12th. Which is maybe not so great, but, you know, you get third in the first moto. How are you feeling about things? The first moto was crazy, first of all, right?
Yeah.
So many, like, lead changes and crashes and stuff, but, you know, you stayed smooth.
No, like, at first, like, my goal was always to be, like, to get a good start, which I did. And after that, it's, like, top maybe five are within 1 second or two. Mm-hmm. So you can't, it's like, it's almost like everybody's having the same pace, so it's a matter of, like, not making mistake, and whoever has the great fitness to mm-hmm. the end will obviously gonna do good. So, but no, the even if it's a third, no, it still felt amazing.
Mm-hmm. And then you back it up with a fourth and second moto again, the podium. When did you realize that you're on the overall top three?
At one point I was in second place and in Moto 2, but made a few mistakes, which, like, the guys behind me catch me or they pass me, but I actually didn't know I was second place overall
mm-hmm.
with running fourth place. I thought maybe Hunter obviously gonna get the overall and RJ
mm-hmm.
gonna finish second and maybe me third, but when I got done with my moto, I guess RJ went down,
mm-hmm.
and that put me into second place. So it was kind
of
cool.
Pretty cool. It's kind of rare when you have two finishes and it equals better than the finishes, right?
Yeah.
Four for second. Sometimes it's terrible when you go like 3-3 and you get fourth or something.
Yeah.
But okay, so how does it feel? You got your first overall podium, second place. I'm sure it was one of your goals this year, right?
Yeah, my goal was to be on the box as much as I can. I know it's my first one, but now, like, once I got the podium, I feel much confidence in myself.
Mm-hmm.
And plus, having two good starts, which makes me comfortable too. So, race after this, like, let's try to do, like, the same thing on starts, and mm-hmm. Like, even if I'm tired at the end, just try to the end. Like, even if you make a mistake, finish the moto and just stay solid. So that's gonna be my next plan.
Mm-hmm. Okay, are you getting a call or something, because it says paused on my screen?
Oh, really?
Yeah. I can hear you, but
is it good now?
No, I still can't see you.
Okay.
Should I stop and call you? Oh, that's good.
That's good?
Yeah. Okay. So how is your fitness right now? Like, I mean, I know, you know, I remember when you were training with some different guys and stuff, and I think I saw you a couple months ago at Greer riding your mountain bike with Yannick. And
fitness is good. Fitness is much better, but yesterday the track was pretty tough. You're pretty much standing the half of the track, so Moto 1 was fine. I was pretty good to the end. And Moto 2, after 3 to 5 minutes into the moto, I was kind of, my back was sore. Like, I was like, I almost couldn't stand up after. Uh-huh. But finish is good. Like, today, usually I'm pretty sore today, but not much today. So overall wise, like, everything is stepping up little by little.
Mm-hmm.
So no, like I said, like, just not like go crazy and just like just build the career.
Yeah. Are you happy with the way that 2021 is going for you so far? I mean, you have your first Supercross win, now your first podium.
I'll never be happy until like I win many times, but yeah, definitely a lot better than last year, obviously, which, like, yeah, makes me happy a little bit.
Mm-hmm. So now that you had a little bit of time since your Supercross win, how do you feel about it? Like, at first, you were kind of in shock, right?
Yeah, at first, it is a surprising thing. Like, you work to get there. Like, you work for winning the races, and you finally did. So there's not really, like, winning races is like not luck, you know.
Yeah.
You have to beat everybody. So, just want to turn that into just want to turn podium, like, no problem after having, like, winning races. Like, makes me feel like
you belong there.
Yeah, like, you know, just want to be there every weekend.
Yeah. Hey, so okay, go on.
Yeah,
but okay, so there was a little point where there's some rumors about teams and everything, but you have re-signed with Pro Circuit Kawasaki for next year, correct? Are you allowed to say? Okay.
No comments.
Okay. But things probably feel pretty good. Yeah, you've had a good year so far, and I'm sure you're on many people's lists. Right?
Yeah. Just pretty good so far.
Okay. What kind of goals do you have for the rest of the year? You know, you said Millville is your favorite track, and that's this weekend, right? So
yeah.
How are you feeling about things?
Oh, I'm just gonna give it all, like, just send it. Like, I'm like it's even like in the championship wise, I'm pretty behind too. So, there's nothing to lose.
Mm-hmm.
Just stay healthy.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. What do you think of the rest of the season? Like, are there any other tracks you're looking forward to past Millville?
Yeah. like, you mean like what do I expect for?
No, no. Are there any other tracks that you like really like the rest of the year?
I like Butts Creek, actually.
Yeah.
The layouts and the off camber that we usually never have.
Mm-hmm.
It's gonna be a hot one, but. That'll be an interesting one.
Mm-hmm.
I love that track.
And then you get one more chance to redeem yourself at your home track, Fox Racing.
Yeah,
right?
I need to go for the revenge on that one, because first moto crashed one time, second moto crashed two times with hitting other riders. So, gotta be a little bit smart.
Yeah. Hey, so what's going on at home? Do you still have? Is the SoCal MTF thing still wide open, or is does COVID change things a little bit?
No, at one point we didn't have any riders because they couldn't come and stuff like that. But right now, like the COVID thing is getting less and less, which is nice. And we have two riders at my house right now. One of them stays for lives here, and the other one stays here for 2 months. So, no, things are getting back to normal.
Yeah. So, how do you feel about, you know, like so many races are relocating to the East Coast? You know, like the entire Star team went to Florida. Do you think staying in Southern California is an advantage or is a disadvantage?
In that case, I don't know. Like Florida, you have different kind of dirt. It's hot, but California, I mean, I don't know. I don't think there's like a, if you live in Florida, it's better, or if you live in California, it's better. Like, I think it's pretty equal.
Mm-hmm. Do you like living here?
I like living in California.
Yeah. Hey, so did you ride Skyline the other day up to the past the ball?
Yeah.
Who did you go there with?
Yeah, Nate, my trainer, and there's his students.
Ah, okay. Was it a good ride?
Yeah, it was. I hate mountain biking, so it was like,
what?
It was tough for me, but
how do you hate it? You're good at it.
I just don't like cycling. Like,
what kind of training do you like?
I like the thing I don't like to do is the cardio.
Oh.
All the muscle exercises are fine, but like doing something really long is kind of boring.
Oh, and you don't like mountain biking?
I don't like mountain biking.
I think you're crazy.
Cool. My balls numb after cycling.
Nice. Well, hey, how was the you know, Anton, the guy that works for me? He said that the fans were going crazy for you at Southwick. How has it been for you with the American fans? Like, I'm sure the win, you know, and Supercross really put you on the radar for a lot of people.
Yeah, I love it. Like, no, like people here is really nice. Like, even if you have like if I have a bad day, people don't really like say like what. Like, what the heck was that race? You know, they try to, like, make you feel motivated. Like, every one of the guys, like, try to help you. So, I don't know, I love it.
Yeah. Feeling more and more at home here then, huh?
Yeah.
Good.
No, it actually, like, helps you motivate for the races or the practice to push. So,
yeah. That's good.
It's sweet.
Cool. Well, hey, Joe, thanks for the time tonight. I'll see you in a couple weeks. I'm coming to Washougal.
Okay.
Yeah, good job this weekend, and let's get a win this year, yeah?
That's the plan.
Okay. Hey, guys, thanks for watching. On behalf of Joe Shimoda, this is Don Maeda signing out for the O'Neill National MX Update. Thanks, Joe.